Hey there, my name is Matti. I built this little Minecraft Copper Golem and let it play Minecraft itself, and this is the reason why. The recently released Minecraft Wild update includes a mob that was voted for in a big mob vote. There were three different mobs to vote from, and one of them was this little adorable dude. He was supposed to press buttons in the game and, you know, just be wholesome. I mean, look at him. He didn't get enough votes to win, but that's alright. I'm not mad about that. I still wanted to pay the golem tribute, and so I built him in real life. I designed him to be able to turn on the spot and move his arms up and down, which in combination should allow him to do a lot of stuff. So after I designed and 3D printed the parts, I just had to sand the parts, prime the parts, wait for the parts to dry, be too impatient to wait for the parts to dry, spray paint the parts, wait again, and do a little bit of soldering, and it was done. So here comes the copper golem, big reveal! I think Copperino is a fitting name. Yeah. If you're wondering what this little opening is for, initially I planned to interact with the golem via sound. That was actually a limited way of interaction. You may at this point ask, but what can he do? Well, first of all, he's super strong and a wonderful dancer. But is he actually good at what he was supposed to do in Minecraft, which is pressing buttons? First I thought, well, let's just do something random that includes buttons, like battling Pokemon against each other. Turns out he's really trash at that and rage quits all the time. So I thought maybe his talent is pressing buttons really fast. I arranged this little button meshing setup with GameCube controllers to test that theory. Button presses per second is not bad, but still slower than me, a mere human. So let's let him play a game he's more familiar with. Let's let him play Minecraft. I made another little controller setup so he can use the joystick of the controller to move the mouse in-game left and right. Don't get me wrong, there's no advanced AI involved in this project. He just chooses left or right randomly. I just want to see where he's gonna end up. I also taped the left mouse button down and put a weight on the W key, so in the game he will constantly move forward and mine. Right at the start he got himself an apple, just to drown himself afterwards, so I had to tape the space bar. After respawning again he just headed for the water, to swim the whole day, and he swam at night as well. Which wasn't a bad technique to avoid monsters, you know? At some point he got back on land and was killed pretty fast. After picking some flowers, Copperino decided it was time to slay a zombie, his only weapon being the remains of another zombie. Ooh, that was a close one. He apparently had a big project in mind because he was mining dirt and gravel for like half an hour. Then was killed by a dirty surprise attack by another zombie. The rest is a little bit sad because he didn't get along with the terrain very well. Also, he didn't get along with the mobs very well. Okay, he's no pro gamer. That's not a problem, right? Let's just try to play together. Maybe he's an amazing assistant. You never know. By the way, if you like this kind of content, please let me know by subscribing to the channel and liking this video.
Thank you very much.
So the golem and I played Minecraft together. You may ask, how is that supposed to work? Well, he still had control over the mouse movement, but now he was also capable of moving the mouse up and down. While the golem controlled the mouse in Minecraft, I controlled the golem via a second keyboard. And because I'm playing with two keyboards, I can't use the mouse with one hand. Which is why I placed the mouse below my left hand on the keyboard, so I still could use the mouse buttons on the mouse wheel. Does this all make sense? No, it does not, but let's see where this is going, alright? Today's the day where we will beat Minecraft, we will not beat Minecraft. Golem. We first need wood. Yeah, I've played this game once. Alright, our first tree down. I think it's very intuitive. Oh my god, yeah. I could play like this forever. Opening the inventory. First wood. Crafting bench. Yeah. The precision in this. And our first pickaxe.
Come on.
There we go. Let's go monster hunting. Woo! I'm gonna go back. Oh, we have copper. You know what we can build? Yes. Oh no. Oh hell no. Oh, I know what we can do now.
Die almost.
Plop. Oh, shall I cook it or shall I just... We need copper for like a big statue of Golemly.
Closing the door.
Okay, it's time for our statue of the Copper Golem. Ah, God. Isn't it amazing? Perfect. I didn't have the patience to build a bigger statue at that point. Sorry. This was very fun to make, actually. Please let me know in the comments what you would like to see on the channel next. I already have a ton of ideas, but still let me know. Thank you very much for watching this. Bye-bye.